everyone, this is Meera Gupta. In previous video lecture, I had started the third chapter from class 10th English book, Footprint Without Feet, named The Midnight Visitor, written by Robert Arthur. Students, this is a mysterious story about a spy named Oswald, who was carrying a secret document on missile, and another agent wanted to have that report, and that's why he came in the midnight to meet Oswald. Okay, in the previous video, introduction was already done, and today let us start the chapter in detail. So I'm going to read the chapter para wise. Kindly listen it carefully. I hope you have book in front of you. Now listen. Para 1. Oswald did not fit any description of secret agent Fowler had ever read. Following him down the musty corridor of the gloomy French hotel where Oswald had a room, Fowler felt let down. It was a small room on the 6th and the top floor, a scarcely a setting for a romantic adventure. Oswald was, for one thing, fat, very fat, and then there was his accent. Though he spoke French and German passably, he had never altogether lost the American accent he had brought to Paris from the Boston 20 years ago. "You are disappointed," Oswald said wistfully over his shoulder. "You were told that I was a secret agent, a spy dealing in espionage and dancer. You wished to meet me because you are a writer, young and romantic." Now just look at the keywords of that para. Musty. Musty here means having a stale, moldy or damp smell. Corridor, a long passage in building from which doors lead into rooms. Gloomy means dark or poorly lit, especially so as to appear depressing or frightening. Now scarcely means only just, almost not. Accent means a distinctive way of pronouncing a language, especially one associated with a particular country, area or social class. And possibly here means just well enough. Okay, so just listen the explanation. Here the writer says that Fowler felt that Oswald did not look like a secret agent at all. Means whenever we just assume the name secret agent in our mind, we found that the agent must be, means his personality must be very attractive. He must be very tall, okay? But Fowler did not find such kind of any association with that agent. He was following Oswald to his room through a smelly and a bit scary corridor. His room was on the top floor, which was the 6th floor of the hotel. Oswald was a very fat man. He was not thin, he was very fat man, and his accent was American, although he had been living in Paris for the last 20 years and could speak a bit of French and German. Oswald was able to speak a bit of French and German language also. Then Oswald tells Fowler, Fowler was a writer who just came near the Oswald to write something on detectives. Okay. Then Oswald tells Fowler that although he was told that he was going to meet a secret agent, a spy agent who had been dealing with dancer, crime scenes and drugs, but Fowler was disappointed. He had to spend this evening in the music hall with an old, poorly dressed, extremely fat man who used traditional methods for making the information traveler rather than beauties delivering to him. Means he was a Fowler just found beyond expectation. Okay, what he expected from the Orcival, that was totally different. He was bored. The meeting was not much very interesting. Okay, now see parrot 2. You envisioned mysterious figure in the night, the crack of pistols, drugs in the wine. And still, you have spent a dull evening in a French music hall with a sloppy fat man who, instead of having masses slipped into his hand by dark-eyed beauties, gets only a prosaic telephone call making an appointment in his room. You have been bored. The fat man chuckled to himself as he unlocked the door of his room and stood aside to let his frustrated guest enter. You are disillusioned, Orcival told him. But take cheer, my young friend. Presently you will see a paper, a quite important paper, for which several men and women have wrecked their lives. Come to me. Some day soon that paper may well affect the course of history. In that thought is drama, is there not? Now see the keywords. Espionage means spying. Envisioned means imagining as a future possibility, visual. Sloppy means carelessly dressed. Prosaic means ordinary. Chuckled means laughed quietly without opening his mouth. And disillusioned means disappointed in someone or something that one discovered to be less good than one had believed. Now listen to the explanation. He, Orcival, then explained that Fowler was bored with him because Fowler was just thinking something else, but he found something else, and that's why Orcival said that no doubt the Fowler was bored with him. As soon as he opened the door of his room, Orcival gave way to Fowler. He entered the room, closed his door, and turned on the light. Then Orcival told Fowler that he had been thinking all wrong, and the best part was yet to come, as they would soon be coming across a paper for which a lot of men and women had wrecked. And that paper is a secret document that is on missile and their lives. And that report was very important. Now you can understand that maybe Orcival, by look, maybe he doesn't look like a spy, but he was having a great brain. And that's why he understood how the Fowler felt for him, but he clarified that maybe he is going to find a very important report. Okay, now see para 3. As he spoke, Orcival closed the door behind him. Then he switched on the light. And as the light came on, Fowler had his first authentic thrill of the day. For halfway across the room, a small automatic pistol in his hand stood a man. Orcival blinked a few times. Max, he whistled. You gave me quite a start. I thought you were in Berlin. What are you doing here in my room? Max was slender, a little less than tall, with features that suggested slightly that crafty pointed countenance of a fox. There was about him, aside from the gun, nothing especially menacing. The report, he murmured. Now see the keywords. Authentic means on undisputed origin and not a copy, genuine. halfway at or to a point between two others. Whistled means spoke beating noisily and heavily. Slender means gracefully thin. Countenance means a person's face or facial expression. Menacing means suggesting the presence of danger or threatening. And murmured means say something in a low or indistinct voice. Okay. Now, student, listen to explanation. Then what happened after saying this? Oswald closed the door behind him and turned on the light. As soon as the light was turned on, Fowler experienced his first thrill of visiting a secret agent. As he saw a man with an automatic pistol standing across the room. Means in the dark side, Oswald and that Fowler was standing there, and Fowler just got a chance to see a man who was having a pistol in his hand, and he was frightened. Oswald recognized the man as Max. Okay, means after seeing that man, that third person, Oswald recognized him, and he said that man was Max. He was another secret spy, and asked him what was he doing in his room when he was supposed to be in the Berlin. Max was thin, a bit short, and his face looked a bit like that of a fox. Means he was very cunning. His personality is compared with the fox. He seemed harmless except the gun he was holding. Means he was, by personality, he was not very dangerous. Only he was having a pistol in his hand, and that's why he was, he just seems that he was dangerous, okay, and nothing else. So here you can see the midnight visitor entered in Oswald's room, and Fowler just got a chance to see him. And Oswald recognized him, that midnight visitor was no one else. That is Max. Now see the next para, para 4. The report that is being brought to you tonight concerning some new missiles, I thought I would take it from you. It will be safer in my hand than in yours. Oswald moved to an armchair and sat down heavily. I'm going to raise the devil with the management this time, and you can bet on it, he said grimly. This is the second time in a month that somebody has gone into my room through that nonsense of a balcony. Fowler's eyes went to the single window of the room. It was an ordinary window against which now the night was pressing balcony. Balcony? Max said, with a raising inflection. No, a pass key. I did not know about the balcony. It might have saved me some trouble had I known. Now see the keywords. Missile, weapons directed by remote control or automatically. Raise the devil means make a noisy disturbance. Grimly means in a very serious, gloomy or depressing manner. Nonsense, a person or thing causing inconvenience or annoyances. Balcony, a platform enclosed by a wall or the balustrade on the outside of a building with access room on upper floor window or door. Inflection means a change in the form of word, typically the ending, to express a grammatical fiction on attributes such as tense, mood, person, number, case, and gender. And pass key here means a master key. Okay. Now listen to the explanation. Max said that he wanted a report about the missiles for which Oswald had been waiting, as he thought that he would be able to keep it more safely. This is said to create humor, as he just wanted a report for his own benefit. What was the purpose of Max arrived there? He wanted to snitch that report that Oswald was having. And what he said? That he said that the report would be better safe in his hand rather than Oswald. Okay? But he was just talking only for his own benefit. Oswald sat down on a chair and started speaking that he would definitely have a fight with the management of the hotel, as this was the second time that someone had climbed up from the balcony of the room. And it was totally disliked by Oswald that someone has arrived in his room through a balcony. And he wanted to complain to the management of the hotel. Then the fowler looked towards the window and saw that it was an ordinary window and that it was pretty much dark outside. The fowler realized that there were no any balcony, that was ordinary window only. So why the Oswald was saying that porch is having the balcony inside? Max said that he came through the master key and did not know about the balcony. Means he used master key to enter the room, not through the balcony, because he didn't know about the balcony. The room was having a balcony. Had he known about it, his work would have become much easier. Max said that if he knew about the balcony, then he should not use the master key to enter the room. The work would be more easy for him. Okay, but how he entered the room? Through window by using master key, not by balcony. Okay? Now see para 5. And this is the last para of this video. And next para we will continue in the next video. It's not my balcony, Oswald said with extreme irritation. It belongs to the next apartment. He glanced explanatory at Fowler. You see, he said, this room used to be a part of a large unit, and the next room through that door there used to be the living room. It had the balcony which extends under my window now. You can get onto it from the empty room two doors down, and somebody did last month. The management promised to block it off, but they haven't. Max glanced at the fowler, who was standing stiffly not far from the Oswald, and waved the gun with a commanding gesture. Please sit down, he said. We have a wait of half an hour, I think. 31 minutes, Oswald said moodily. The appointment was over, was for 12:30. Okay? Now see the difficult words. Glanced. Glanced means take a brief or hurried look. Explanatory means serving to explain. Stiffly means in a manner that is not relaxed or friendly. Waved moved to and fro with the swearing motion while remaining fixed at one point. Commanding means having a position of authority. And gesture a movement of part of the body, especially a hand or the head, to express an idea or meaning. Evilly means morally wrong or bad. Now listen to the explanation. What happened then? When Oswald just informed him about the balcony that was having near his window, the Oswald continued that it was not his balcony through which people had tried coming in, but was of the next apartment. And that balcony belonged to next apartment. He then started explaining things to Fowler that his room used to be a part of a large unit and the room next to his room used to be a living room. Then he said that it had the balcony that came till the window of his room. Means the balcony was connected to the next apartment. Then he said that to climb up to his room, one needed to go to the empty room which was two rooms away from his room and climbed up the balcony. Means here the Oswald was playing a very tricky role. Okay, he just disclosing the wrong things in front of the another secret agent. Okay, then he said that somebody did climb up the balcony last month as well. Okay, means he was revealing the truth, and that actual it was not truth. He also told Fowler that the management had told him that they would surely get it blocked, but they still hadn't done so. It means Oswald wanted to clarify that still there was a balcony just near the window which is connected to the next large room, next apartment. Max looked at Fowler, who was standing near Oswald. Max asked Fowler to sit down, as there was still half an hour for the report to reach Oswald. Now they have to wait at least half an hour to have that report. Oswald joked that it was not 30 minutes but 31 minutes that were left for the report to reach them. The report was supposed to come in around 12:30 at night. Okay, so that's why the three person have to wait for half an hour to just reach that report. And Oswald said these all things very clearly, very truly to the another spy named Max. Okay, so means he tried to befool Max, and that's why he was just discussing about the balcony, discussing about the next apartment, discussing about the empty room. But in fact, there was no balcony, no apartment connected to his room. This all things was not right, but he wanted to befool Max. Okay, and that's why he said that there was a balcony near his window. And he also said that they have to wait half an hour so that they will able to reach that report, because the report will be arrived near about 12:30 at midnight. Okay, so that's why here you can see Max was the midnight visitor who went near Oswald to meet him. Okay, so here the explanation is end up, and the next part we will start in the next video. I hope you understood it well. Go through once again the video and listen it carefully and try to understand. See you in the next video. Goodbye. Have a nice day.